Hello. One of the most important things to consider when we are doing statistics is to consider the type of data that we are going to be analyzing. And so we're going to be looking at data classification in this presentation. The types of data that we consider come in two broad forms. One of those is qualitative data, which tends to be based on text. So things like attributes and labels are non-numerical. Quantitative data, as it sounds, is numerical. So anything that can be enumerated will count here as quantitative data. In this example, we see both qualitative and quantitative data. The names of students are qualitative, their text, and the quantitative portion is the GPA for each student. We can further refine our classification of data into four categories. And those are actually hierarchical categories. Nominal has to do with unranked qualitative data. Ordinal has to do with ranked qualitative data. Interval has to do with quantitative data. So interval is dealing with numbers. And with interval, there is no real zero. With ratio, we have quantitative data where the number zero is a meaningful number. Examples of nominal level data are colors in the US flag, names of students in a class, or textbooks that are assigned this semester. Ranked ordinal data come in several different forms. Here are some examples. Class standing, such as freshman, sophomore, junior, senior, because those labels describe a ranking in terms of the number of years somebody has attended. Numbers on the back of each player's shirt are also ordinal descriptions. In fact, one might actually consider those nominal as well, simply because they're just descriptions of a person's identity on the team. And in fact, as we'll see, as we move up the hierarchy of classifications, that each higher level measurement also contains lower level measurements within it. So ordinal level data can be converted to nominal. Top 50 songs played on the radio, that's another good example of ordinal data, where number one would be more preferred than number two, for instance. Examples of interval data include temperatures, and by that we're not talking about Kelvin, because Kelvin has a theoretical zero. But if we're talking about Fahrenheit or Celsius, those include negative temperatures. The number zero is simply a position on a scale. So this is interval. Years on a timeline are similar. Atlanta Braves World Series victories. That's another example. And because this is a higher level than ordinal and interval, we can convert interval level data to either ordinal or nominal level data. And finally, ratio, as we said, has a meaningful zero. Ages, somebody cannot be negative in terms of their age. Grade point average. Nobody can perform lower than zero on grades. And weights. Now, there's no such thing as a negative weight. And finally, this table summarizes the four levels of measurement by their characteristics. All of them can be put in categories, the data, that is. From ordinal on up, the data can be arranged in a particular order. And from interval up, we can subtract data values, something we can't do with ordinal or nominal. And finally, ratio, we can determine if one data value is a multiple of another. We can't do that with interval.